I will notice also that the left, which has been suggesting that if you oppose the hormone replacement therapy for children or transgender surgery, this means that you are killing trans kids, is the language they use, that you're killing trans kids if you don't want kindergartners indoctrinated in the idea they can be a member of the opposite sex. Suddenly, they're very sensitive about the use of language. So number one, if you have been using that sort of language, I have no use for you complaining about the use of language like groomer. Number two, if people are saying that you are grooming children politically, you are grooming children politically. That is not the same thing as grooming children sexually. But the baseline notion that you're talking to kids apart from their parents because the parents are the enemy and you are the source of their sexual knowledge is creepy and weird at the very least. And it is politically motivated, which is to say that it is perverse. Okay, so that's angle number one, is the left is trying to say, well, it may be true. The vast majority of parents and Americans agree that we shouldn't be sexually indoctrinating small children. But if you use the word groomer, then you're the real problem. No, you're still the real problem, even if the use of the word groomer with regard to, for example, sexual abuse of children is over the top and misstated. Political grooming is indeed happening. Okay, so that's number one. The second thing they've been doing is they've been saying, you know, the right is declaring these culture wars on corporate America for no reason. So Brian Stelter is doing this routine. He said, the right has decided that Disney is the top issue. No, you guys did. You guys did. Here is the timeline. The timeline is Florida passed a bill. The bill is very obvious. The bill says something very clear. You're not allowed to sexually indoctrinate small children. You guys went to Disney. And you know that Disney is the biggest employer in the state of Florida. And so you yelled at them. And you said, if you don't say something, we are going to just keep reporting that you're not saying anything. And so you cudgeled them into making a statement. And then you cudgeled Disney into going further than that and holding an all-hands town hall meeting in which members of the upper echelons of Disney overtly said that they wish to mainline gay propaganda, their words, into children's programming. And then we noticed. So if anybody brought Disney into this fight, it's you, you jackasses. So here's Brian Stelter blaming the right for the left cudgeling corporations into going woke.
The talking point on the right is about protecting kids from the dangers of the Walt Disney Company. Really. But Disney is just a stand-in. It's just a symbol for something bigger. A conservative backlash to growing acceptance of gay and transgender people. A conservative fear that traditional beliefs are being trampled on. And there are entire networks that program to this fear and many politicians that react to it. That's the story here.
It's the story is that they are so tolerant and that they are so good and they are so wonderful. And that's why people are angry at Disney. No, you guys forced Disney to go completely radical on this subject and then talk about indoctrinating kids in their programming with this stuff. And then we reacted. So no, this is on you. Now, all the woe is me. Why am I being attacked? Why is this all happening? Because you started the fight, gang. And the more corporations do this, the more stupid they are. This is true on every woke front. So the dumbest example of this. So every day there's a new corporation doing something unbelievably dumb in terms of social politics. So the other day we had Oreo, a cookie company, pushing coming out content. Now we have Cracker Jack, which is a company that is nationally famous for being in a song about baseball, calling itself Cracker Jill to promote feminism. Now, let me just point out, Cracker Jill is not going to sell you a lot of Cracker Jack. It really is not. This is incredibly stupid. Cracker Jack is going to get sold at ball games because it's literally part of the song that we sing during the seventh inning stretch. Turning Cracker Jack into Cracker Jill is bad marketing. It is stupid marketing. It provides you with no win. But they all feel like all these companies feel like they have to do this because they know, number one, that they'll get attention. And number two, that the left will cheer them for their progressivism. So now we have Cracker Jill, which frankly just sounds like a racist lady from like the 1950s who's yelling at a black kid, Cracker Jill. Right? It's weird, isn't it? You're like, Cracker Jill? Okay, anyway, here is a song about Cracker Jill. The woman singing, by the way, is black, so this has nothing to do with race.
Take me out to the ball game. Take me out to the crowd.
Buy me
some peanuts and Cracker Jill. No one can stop you if you have the will. So let's root for a girl's dream.
Wait, that's tennis. That's the wrong sport. Face to the game. That's hockey. That's also the wrong sport.
And we'll run.
That's basketball.
Are
any of the people playing here going to be girls?
Yeah.
I guess there are a bunch of women in the background who are throwing around a baseball. That's the only baseball. Cracker Jill. No one can stop you unless it's a man pretending to be a woman who will stop you in every available sport and defeat you with alacrity. Cracker Jill. Oh, my Lord. Who's going to buy this? Seriously. Yeah, continue down these lines. Seriously, just continue. Clarity before agreement, as my friend Dennis Prager says. So if you guys want to do this, if this is the path you want to go down, just understand you're alienating at least half of the people who buy your product. Not because I'm not in favor of women playing sport. I have two daughters. They both play sports. Oh, the little one is a little too young. The bigger one plays tennis. But, you know, I have no problem with women playing sports, but hijacking classic American brands to turn them into feminist icons is a weird move. It's a weird move. And then after the left does this, like, why aren't these corporations, why are Americans reacting badly? Yeah, because of you guys, because of you. Did you know that every single like creates one additional leftist tier? That is just science.